there is a box when you say that, when it's in a bad moment with a project, not knowing what to do, you go out of the office, give a walk, or go home and paint it. Design very well, but painting also annoying. So, and sometimes making this without thinking at all in the project will come something that would take to the solution to the problem he had forgotten, he had put away. It's a little for that reason. Also, relax, I said already, and to be free from the preoccupation, obsession, or project. And also for pleasure, because I began drawing very soon. I didn't want to be an architect. By different reasons, I became an architect. But I never lost the need to make drawings, so I have drawn. But I received once a call, or probably received the first castanheira, then told me, this was the usual, told me, Albert, there is a Chinese that wants to speak with you. Or that gives this idea. I want to build the Picasso Museum, said he. And I said, it's not to build. It was an idea that I developed for Madrid, but not to build. But he said again, I want to build. And I explained something, and he said again, no, I will build it. And in a moment, I told him, there is a small problem, is that it will be very difficult to buy Guernica or to buy the sculpture of the woman. I said, no problem, you make it. So, with that argument, I have no other thing to say, and I said, okay. We reduced the scale, the dimension, produced dimension, because as it was not built to build, I exaggerated. And I said to Martha Thorne, I must make it enormous. Then I had to reduce. So we began the construction, and in the end I made one sculpture in Corten and one sculpture in marble with the naked. Probably Picasso turned in the tomb. So they are there. And so it was the story. But this happened not strange for me in China, because in China we had me in the Carlos. The opportunity to build, for instance, to give an example, four museums, or five perhaps. I don't know what happened, so many. And houses and laboratories and so. So, and always with the clients that follow the process with enthusiasm. They want things with quality, and they were enthusiastic, and they spoke, they would make always big dinner for 20 people, so round table, every 5 minutes, 2 minutes. What was more difficult was to take so many.
Antonio, I have a question.
Of course.
Alvaro, may I ask you a question?
Yes.
What is the process of an idea that you had for Madrid how do you take that idea and either keep it in your mind or transform it years down the road for another place? What is the essence of that?
Yes, thank you. When I have a project, doesn't matter which project, my first reaction is to be in panic, afraid not to find something interesting at least. So, in the first phase, I make a lot of sketches, some a little crazy, but I don't mind. What I don't want to see more and more is the white paper. So I began making sketches, and then it gives a lot of ideas to develop. And then there is the period of critique to things. So this is not possible, this out, this out, until we make surrounding the ideas and the and then we get this to develop. Of course, this parkour that I describe in a simple way, simplistic way, the reality includes a review of the things I saw already of other architects. From the 15th century or 20th century, if possible 22nd century. And so this evolution, a little chaotic, is referred to different things that impressed me. Not that I choose consciously, but they come. So that is the reason why, in my opinion, I don't make copies, is that I use so many references that even I cannot, things that I saw, I cannot consciously use them because I had to choose the first and second. So they come. But we have a very good friend that is subconscious. And when we are in panic, subconscious comes. I left you. And okay. So it's more or less this process. Then is the long process of making things rational, totally rational, and finding the techniques. And I must mention the other friends, not only subconscious, the engineers and the architects who we work with at the moment, and also the architects that I saw something also in a book. So the problem is to have all the life food for our mind. And then things come when it happened many times that someone tells me, looking for a project, this is an influence of fun. And I began thinking, then I said, you are right. But I never, during the process, had the idea, who would be this? If someone gives this reflection, who will be this? Much for us, because there was not a need for beauty, there was a need for architects. The reason of architecture, that exists architecture and architects, is the search of beauty. Because the engineers put up the buildings, make the structure, treatment of air, okay, no problem. Only there is this small thing, simple thing, that is beauty. But beauty has many other things in the buildings. must not be specially noticed. What you say, like, I feel approaches, not either by commenting or give some justification of that commenting. For instance, detail in a building, detail of the door or everything, has to be perfect, has to be very, very well designed. But if it is well designed in a sense that you enter the room and you notice that detail, whatever it is, is very bad. It destroys the unity of space, the consistency of space. And with beauty is the same. What we were telling, yes, beauty is new. But beauty cannot be, also in architecture, something that imposes on the others. It's a part of it. It's not so special.
I come in through the parking lot, so sometimes, like the TWA, a project can make you lose your mind a little bit. In your case, you don't lose your mind, but your mind is in the project, quite literally, in this photograph by Carlos Castaneda of the Mimesi Museum gigantic model, where you're testing out the ceilings. And so I think this relationship with the TWA brings me to this building again, which is this idea of the bridge. What does this transition of the bridge mean, other than, of course, solving a very clear issue of separation between two buildings? So how does this bridge work? Why does it exist in this way? How does it relate to its context?
I have, well, this project.
Yeah.
This, I was very fortunate in this project because there were things that conducted to what remained the solution attributed quicker than in many other buildings. One thing, it was very difficult, and the architects work based more than everything in difficulties. If you have something difficult, you go on it. Was difficult, and there were many conditionings and demands. If we don't have conditionings, we don't know where to begin, how to begin. That is everything in the world of things. If you have not demands, in a way, is the same. The worst client we can have is one that says, make as you want. I don't want to condition you. That is it's tragic. Then, here's what I have. I have the instruction said by administration, much by you even, that people didn't want, in Serralves, didn't want an annex to a building, wanted a whole building that had that home and this home. So that was very important, and comes immediately the idea that the bridge must be space to be used, cannot be really a narrow bridge. The other thing is, the garden is classified, and all the trees that please don't put down the trees as much as possible. So I had, in a way, I had almost two parallel volumes, and I realized it cannot be so simple because I would have to destroy this tree and this and this and this. So the building had put up a roof for the space, not to hurt the cabin. Okay. Distribution archives, and then one floor for painting, for exhibitions, art exhibitions, and one for architecture. Recently, Serralves increased the interest for architecture, and so there is the idea to have a special care. Is not something to forget, and it is not art. It's not art. It's not art. It's not science. And I ask myself sometimes, what is art? Is art and science and everything also because working projects are scientists. Common in different kinds of approach. What more I have to help me? Well, I have, I know, was very quick. So, approval of project was very quick. And I am not used to this unhappily. Because of the situation today is we put in the department, in the community, in the municipality or so a project, and we forget it. But it takes so much time. Legally, there are 20 days to give an opinion, but nobody makes it, no municipality. And if we make, I never made a friend of consequences because I knew that someone friend that had put this problem. 20 days passed, so it's approved. And the functionary that attended him said, do it, and we'll never in this municipality approve a project. And this is a reality. Then here was weak. So at the same time, I was thinking all the problems of the building. I did not have intervals. So it was the unity of this building comes much from the unity in time of doing it, executing it. Many times I forget. I have to call someone that worked with me and ask, look, I am an old man, I forget things, so what was this, Then here I did not have this problem, it was very quick. There was a team from the museum that followed works, made the assistance together with us, together mainly with Maria, the collaborator that followed the whole. So it was not so tiring for me. I was very comfortable. That was quick. And for tired to hear that I am very, I make things very slowly and late, and so I had the proof. I said, things to go normal, I am weak. Things are lost in the departments, different departments. And this is a situation terrible. I have in Porto two buildings interesting by the river. It had represented to 26 departments. 1996. And it went well, slowly, months. The passing first, then the second, and so on. In the end, what we saw, we won, is one thing called the APA. Even the name is frightening, APA. And the APA ambience,
the environment,
decided that the region of Marais,
the tide.
The tide, I worked with because it was the river, they had decided to put it more. So it means the two buildings I had there cannot be because it was too much, you know. But also means that the prevision is that the margin of Gaia and the margin of Porto, everything, all the houses, all this will disappear. Maybe it happens. Why avoid more two or three when there is the whole town? Now, so a quick project is the best for the project and for the health of the architect.
I can respond to that. I would say something, Alvaro. Maybe you feel the same, but I think there's a great luxury in having more and more years in your career. And the luxury is, for me in any case, I don't care what people think of me anymore. I really don't care. That's one thing. And the other luxury is that I want things to go, I'm in a hurry. I have less time, so I want things to go fast. And I think also because what you said, then you don't forget, which is great, but when I look at your architecture, you've had so many experiences, so much experience building, traveling, dealing with clients, struggling with projects. Maybe now you don't need so much time. You know, maybe because it's all in there, and it's just a question of distilling it, and you have practice in that. And I think that's one thing, I look around the room and I see people who are young and I say, forget GPT chat, travel, go to the movies, talk to your friends, look at everything. Don't be pragmatic, and this is a pragmatic American saying this, don't be pragmatic. Fill your mind like Álvaro Siza, it's the best thing you can do.
Yes, if we are able to go on learning, that is, the nation is a good thing for work. For the body is not. I think it is necessary, I feel necessary, or it happens without thinking of it, to maintain some kind of ignorance. I mean, some type of ingenuity. To be in a way to go on a little naive, because naive can mean on also opening.
today you were at that window, and you were talking a bit about Siza's windows in general. I told you a little story from Siza's childhood, from when he got pneumonia, and so he hated the valley view, even though it was beautiful, and about selecting viewpoints. And you mentioned something interesting about sort of how his buildings open up into the landscape, if you want to elaborate on that.
I was looking to these photos and I remember two other chances I had when the food things, speaking of the reality of the old museum and the need to make not as an annex, and the access being by this kind of bridge. Two good things that happen. You see that the one of organs is harmless to this bridge, touch the building without becoming something not natural. And I had chance that in the old building there were two elements, a kind of low window and a higher part, I think it's the lift there. And between the two, they touch in triangle, and there is here another rest. And looking at it, I said, it has to go there. That is a sight. If it is there, it's floating. So part of this fundamental point here. The other thing is that this road that obliged to bridge avoided to put buildings, touching which would be a big volume and well, would not work. So I had the chance that I had a recommendation and I recognized it. Never touch this road, because it's the main road that goes to the office of the museum and to the garage. So the bridge was needed, separating buildings was needed. Finding the difficulty, how the bridge can touch the old building, was there on site. And the trees, the old trees, of course.
So the answer is in the site, as you often say. And going back to this, the evolution process was one of adding things or one of removing things?
One of them.
Era o seu processo de arquitetura? Foi um de acrescentar coisas ou de retirar coisas durante o projeto?
Este
projeto específico.
Well, this is a very special project for me. Because, as I mentioned already, I found answers immediately there. I described some. So there was not that expectation, fear about the evolution of process. But normally, in most of projects I have to do, is mainly a process of taking things to everything, because to conform a space, if you think of one building is a volume, to make from it spaces, which is the goal, or the intended, you have to take all this. explore in detail for me what happens is to take many, many things, as many as possible. Because this feeling, if it was not studied with much engagement of an engineer, also would have leads, things to make, to put the water down, signs, many things written. There are still many that, in my opinion, are not needed. As to have on a red
sign.
No. The fire extinguisher.
On the red, on the red machine.
Yeah.
Why on the red machine? But then we have something to see for safety, for security. One day we have to look, another day we are looking with menaces. And so what we have, one of the interesting is exactly, thank you.
I think it's interesting the question that Francesco D'Alpo is proposing, but here, from this point of view of this photo, I think what we feel is not that kind of exercise of adding or removing. It's more like the interesting thing is the possibility of building the interior, and then the volume results with a very strong naturality. And then when we visit the interior, we see that the interconnection of the spaces is the main thing that we can have here, and we cannot wait, now that we have seen it empty and late, to see it with exhibitions, because I think it's going to be beautiful.
Yeah, here, this is, I said, a special case. I could not simply take okay. I had to say, excuse me, may I? Pardon me. And,
yes. To the tree. And so the pavilion that you helped us open, in a sense, with the conference of the human being, that was the theme of the conference. What the future of the human being. And in this pavilion you found a lot of other triangulations, of other volumetric articulations. And today, when you were looking back at the building, I remember you coming up to the window, looking back through here, and hinting, oh, look at that ceiling, look at the floor. It's not pointing where one would obviously assume it should be pointing, but instead sort of deviating us to a specific place. So I brought the actual sketches of the selecting of this moment. And perhaps you could speak a little bit about this sort of hinting in space, of subtly sort of manifesting how people should move through it, perhaps.
Yeah, I really appreciated Alvaro's words about space, and saying that architecture is creating spaces in space, because I think that that's it's obvious through the feelings that people have as they move through the space. And I'm glad that the building is empty now, because you go forward and turn and go back, you look out the window and then you look at the details. But you do it all with this feeling that you are in spaces that are changing. Maybe because the light is changing, like the volumes, the shape, and things like that.
Continuo a admitir que os seus ensinamentos, o seu trabalho, possa continuar a ser seguido por muitos jovens que aqui estão e muitos outros que vamos encontrar do outro lado. E aí, que se Deus me for,
não
podes
querer. Não, go ahead.
But I never completely get out of this way of life.
That's very
so cool. I feel that my way as architect is the way that will finish.
I hope not. And you have already explained it. You teach us that you can work in different situations. Different briefs and geographies, and always with the intensity that you put in everything you do.
say two things. One, I have to totally agree with you and Siza that this passion, the vision that architects bring to a project is something incredibly special. And that's something that I hope we never lose. On the other hand, I think it would be not the naivete that Siza speaks about, but I think it would be ignorance if we said we should always do architecture in the same way, we should always do things by hand, we should always, because there we have to look at the system around architecture, we have to look at the trades, we have to look at how much we pay people, we have to look at the image of the architect as the starving artist that shouldn't be able to pay the electric bill. And we also have to look at the reality nowadays of, we have a wonderful client in museums. What is the essence of your architecture? What is that quality or that part of the process or that element that gives it life and is the meaning of architecture? We can strip away so many things, but you cannot strip away the essence. And that essence is what probably we should be educating future architects to hold on to. And I said to Antonio, it's not drawing, it's not the computer, it's not this. What is the essence?
And in the end, she was answering from her point of view that what we are looking for is the extraordinary or fantastic life of a certain person, that is the artist. And I think this is very, very interesting and very important for us, because we like so much the architecture of Álvaro Siza, but mainly the architecture reflects his life and his personality, And so is this interaction that is so appealing and so natural and that we love so much.
Well, I would open up to perhaps if anybody has any questions. Nobody has any questions, everybody wants to go to dinner. Well, I know Enrico would probably like to say something. We have a client with us today, who's doing a project with Siza.
They'll bring you a microphone.
Enrico started producing Siza's first design objects, like this mirror that you see on the sketch, the Álvaro mirror.
Poi subuglio a parte dell'atto di Bessier perché domani alle 11 devo incontrare Siza e mi presenterà un progetto per me di architettura. Quindi sono nelle condizioni di chi è, come